Welcome to CERN, welcome to LHC.2, one of the 8 surface points on the surface of the Large Hadron Collider. This is the home of the ALICE experiment that is situated about 60 meters underground, right below my feet. ALICE stands for a Large Ion Collider experiment, and it is one of the 4 detectors reading the collisions generated by the Large Hadron Collider. It's a very special detector studying the conditions of matter right after the very beginning of the universe at the Big Bang. We are here to share with you a major and spectacular operation of transport and installation of some of the components of the ALICE detector that have been undergoing a major upgrade in the last few months. These operations was happening here on the surface a few days ago. We've been filming it and following it. In particular, we have been following the time projection chamber, one of the main components of the detector, a big piece, 14.2 tons heavy, while it was transported from the clean room right there, where it has been upgraded in the last few months, through the shaft in the building right behind me, inside the TPC cavern. You can see how the TPC is being descended into the shaft, precisely 56 meters deep. This was quite a delicate operation because the TPC, as you can see, is almost as large as the shaft itself. It measures 50 meters in length. It has 90 cubic meters in volume, so the tolerance was very little. The piece is extremely cumbersome and heavy, but also delicate and sophisticated. So you can see the ALICE engineers running around the gangways, making sure that everything is under control. The movement was quite slow. It took an entire hour to descend 56 meters, and it took, all in all, 3 days for the whole operation to be completed. The operation is now complete. The TPC is underground. We are going to join very soon the ALICE technical coordinator, Werner Riegler, to ask him questions about the operation, the piece, what it measures, what it does, why it's been upgraded. We are in the ALICE cavern with Werner Riegler, the technical coordinator of the ALICE collaboration. Hi, Werner. So we are here and the movement of the time projection chamber, your TPC, has just started. Tell me, what's happening?
So this is now, after the move from the clean room to the cavern, this is now the final move of the TPC into the ALICE detector to the interaction point. It's a very critical moment because we have changed a lot on the TPC during this upgrade. We also have changed a lot on the ALICE detector. So we still have lots of new services, and we have to make sure it fits. The clearances are very tight. So there are many people all around the TPC to look that we have no interferences and that we can move the TPC really to the final position.
And it's moving very slowly.
Yes, it's moving slowly, of course, because everybody has to look that there are no things in the way. The TPC has about 15 tons. We pull it with hydraulic checks. And of course, if there's something in the way, you would not feel it. You have to really look to make sure that we don't break anything. And this is why it's a very slow movement, why we have many people around the TPC to have a look.
Okay, and now, once it's in its final position inside, there are all sorts of connections to be made, right?
So yes, what we do now is the TPC will go to the final position, okay? And then we will align it, okay? It has to be aligned properly to a millimeter or so or better with the nominal beam line from the...
Very precisely.
Very precisely with the beam line. And once this is done, then we move it back a little bit and then the beam pipe will be installed. This is the piece that will then connect the two sides of the LHC tunnel where the beam will pass through.
It's like a Lego, basically. Alice is made of many different components. Yes. The TPC is very, very big.
Yes.
It's beautiful to look at, and it's very delicate, as we've seen. The transport down the shaft was also very careful, and now it's very carefully being inserted inside. What's the role of the TPC in the whole detector?
Yeah. So the TPC is our main tracking detector.
It means time projection chamber. Let's also explain why this name, what does it mean exactly?
So the task of the TPC is to track the particles, to make the particles visible that are produced in the heavy ion collisions. And the trick with the TPC is that this is a big volume that is filled with a very light gas, with neon gas.
Yeah.
And as particles are moving through this gas, these particles are ionizing the gas, and these electrons and ions that are produced there are then detected by the TPC, and this is how we can make the path of the particles
visible. The nice, beautiful tracks of the Alice event. And now that is going to be in half an hour or so, because the movement is low, but it takes time. But it's also a short movement right now that you're doing. It's the final part.
Yeah, it's about 2-3 meters that we move in. As I said, it will go to the final position. And after that, we move back a little bit, and then we install the beam pipe, which is a very important element of a particle detector.
We will also see that while it's being done. So we are in for more excitement. The beam pipe is also new. It's a new beam pipe that you're putting in.
The beam pipe is new. The beam pipe is also a very important element of a particle detector, because we want to be as close as possible to the collision point with our sensors.
Right.
The machine, of course, they want the pipe as big as possible to be sure there are no interferences. So there is a long negotiation with the machine to be able to agree on the smallest possible beam pipe. And the one we will have is about 4 centimeters in diameter. And the important thing for the beam pipe is also that the wall is only 800 micron thick. If this would be a big steel pipe, the particles that are produced inside in the collision, when they go through this pipe, they would be completely diverted and our measurement would be not possible. So this is why there has to be the least amount of material possible around the collision point. This is why this beam pipe is of this very thin beryllium, which is very fragile. So you can imagine if we have this very brittle object and then around this we have to install our detectors, it's a very delicate operation.
Amazing, amazing. So this is going to happen very soon. We will follow that. But before looking at the beam pipe, we're going to follow one of your collaborators, Roberto Di Via, who could go inside Alice before the TPC was inserted and show us one of the most innermost places where it's very rare to go in, because normally TPC is always in. And these are the muon absorber and the trigger. Before looking at that, tell us more, what do these components do?
So yeah, the muon absorber is one big object inside, which is absorbing all the particles in the forward region, and all the muons are the particles that manage to go through, because behind that there's the big muon spectrometer that should just measure these particles.
Yeah.
So this is a very massive object at the other side here of our detector. And the trigger, this is the electronics that will decide on the readout of the detector. It has to be very close to the detector such that the propagation time of the signals is small. And this is on the back side, a bit under the magnet, and you will visit that and have a look at that.
Amazing. So we take a look at these very innermost components of Alice and after the beam pipe insertion. In the meantime, thank you very much, Werner. And I leave you back to your very delicate and important work today.
Okay,
thank you.
So this is the muon absorber. It is like a big sponge. that takes all the low energy particles which are going that way. So everything that passes is a high energy particle, mainly muons. And on the other side of this absorber is a series of detectors which are dedicated only to the muon physics. So it's like a big shower going towards the back of Alice. So this is the deepest point in Alice. Here we are at minus 56 meters. And this is the trigger. As you can see, we are in the bunker. This is solid concrete, so no particles can come in here. And this is the heart of Alice. This is where the decision, if something interesting happened, is taken. And this is done on the fly. This was done during run two. During run three, it will be a different scheme. This heart will be a bit more relieved. It will beat a bit less. But nevertheless, it will be the core of the taking of data for the whole of Alice.